In this video, we'll take a look at how to calculate the standard deviation and the variance. The standard deviation and variance are measures of variability. They both indicate the overall amount of variability or spread in a set of scores. The two measures are closely related. The standard deviation is just the square root of the variance. The standard deviation can be thought of as the average or typical distance that values vary from the mean. A standard deviation of 2, for example, would indicate that scores vary around the mean by about 2 points. So, if we had a standard deviation of 2, that would mean that some values were further than 2 points away from the mean, and some values were closer than 2 points. But loosely speaking, the average distance was about 2 points from the mean. So some are a little more, some are a little less, some may be exactly 2 points away, but sort of an average distance is about 2 points. That's what we're getting at here with the standard deviation. Next, we'll take a look at how to calculate the standard deviation and variance. In this example, we'll look at the population variance and standard deviation. We'll calculate the sample values in another video. So suppose that we have the following values, with scores for 5 people on the variable x. We'll go ahead and calculate the variance and standard deviation on this example. In terms of the calculations, we'll begin with calculating the mean of x. So to find the mean of x, we want to go ahead and add all these values together and then divide by 5 the total number of values. So you can see we did that here. We have 10, 18, and 20 divided by 5. Which gives us a mean of 4. Next, we need to calculate deviation scores. Deviation scores subtract the mean from each value. They're called deviation scores because they indicate how far each value deviates or departs from the mean. So in other words, how far is each value away from the mean? That's what a deviation score measures. Let's go ahead and take a look at how to find those. Okay, so here I have my deviation scores, and recall that my mean is 4. So here's the original values, and my mean is 4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract this mean of 4 from each of these values. And you can see that here. So I have 6 minus 4 is 2, 4 minus 4 is 0, 5 minus 4 is 1, 3 minus 4 is a negative 1, and then 2 minus 4 is a negative 2. Now if you look at these deviation scores, notice we have a plus 2, 0, plus 1, negative 1, negative 2. Notice how the positive deviation scores add up to 3, and the negative deviation scores add up to negative 3. If you add up all of these, they sum to 0. Now that's always the case with deviation scores. And I summarize that here. When we add these values up, positive 3, negative 3, they always equal 0. And the reason that this is always the case is because the mean acts as a balance point in the distribution, with the sum of the deviation scores above the mean equal to the sum of the deviation scores below the mean. That's always the case. If you calculate deviation scores and find that they don't add up to 0, then that means that a mistake was made in the calculations and you want to double check your work. So they should always add to 0 by definition. Okay, after we find the deviation scores, we need to square each of these values. And squaring the deviation scores gets rid of the negative numbers. So let's take a look at that. These first two columns you saw in the earlier slide where we calculated the deviation scores here. Now all we're doing is we're taking these deviation scores and we're squaring them. And that's what we have right here. 2 squared is 4. 0 squared is 0, 1 squared is 1, negative 1 squared is positive 1, and negative 2 squared is positive 4. So notice how we have all positive values now. Next, we need to sum the squared deviation scores. This is also known as the sum of the squares, or SS. Now you'll see this term a lot in statistics texts, SS, or sum of the squares. And here's our last column in our previous calculations where we squared each of those deviation scores. All we need to do is add these values together. So 4 plus 0 plus 1 plus 1 plus 4. And we've done that right here. This gives us the sum of the squares, and when we add these together, 5, 6, and 4 is 10. So notice that the sum of the squares, or SS, is 10. With SS solved for, we can now calculate the variance. The formula for the variance is, the variance is equal to SS over N. And here's our values that we saw before. SS is 10, N is 5. As a reminder, N just counts how many values we have, so there's 5 values. So to calculate the variance, we're just going to take 10 and divide it by 5. And that gives us a variance of 2. The standard deviation is just the square root of the variance. So this is the standard deviation here, and it's equal to the square root of the variance. Recall that the variance was 2, so therefore the standard deviation is equal to the square root of 2, which works out to be 1.414. In summary, we had a variance of 2 and a standard deviation of 1.414. Now, as a brief review before we close, to calculate the standard deviation and variance, you want to complete the following steps. We found the mean, and then recall we calculated deviation scores, where we subtracted the mean from each of these values, and then we squared those deviation scores, and then we added up those squared values, and that gave us SS, and then we just divided SS by N to find the variance, and then once we found the variance, we took the square root of that value, and that gave us the standard deviation. Okay, that's it. This concludes the video on calculating the standard deviation and variance. Thanks for watching.